Next, present perfect tense. I hope so all of you are aware of tenses, okay? Otherwise you'll have problem. When we talk about the immediate past, then we use the present perfect tense. For example, Ram has written a beautiful essay. So we see over here, this sentence is present perfect tense. Why it is present perfect tense? Because it is talking about the immediate past. How will you identify it, whether it is present perfect tense? You will see in the present perfect tense, after Ram is the subject over here. After that, you will either have has or have according to the subject. And then after that, automatically you will get verb 3. That means written. Okay? This is third person singular, that is why you have over here has. If this would have been plural, then you would have had to written have over here. So this is the present perfect tense. Active voice. Why it is active voice? Again, we see over here the subject does something. Ram has written a beautiful essay. So this is the object over here, object, make the object into subject. So capital letter, a beautiful essay, okay, a beautiful essay has, you write has over here, has. And now you have to write something new over here, which is not there in the question, that is been, B-E-E-N, a beautiful essay has been written, third form of the main verb in the question, by Ram, in this way, a beautiful essay has been written, means this is the formula over here, has been written. If this is not there in your answer, then your answer is wrong. Got it? Another example. Okay, we have completed the task. Task means work over here. Again, we see your subject. We is the subject. Now your subject is plural. That is why over here I am written have over here, because the subject is we, more than one. We have completed the task. The task, object, verb, doing word. Change the task. Now you have to be careful over here. The task. Now you don't write have over here, because now your subject has changed. First it was we, means more than one, plural. That is why you had to write over here have. But now your subject is the task. Therefore, singular. You have to write over here has. The task has. Okay, understood? Been. Third form of completed is completed only. So third form is already written over there. When you are solving present perfect tense, past perfect tense, the third form of verb is always there. So you don't have any, just copy this down, okay? The task has been completed. By, object of we is us. I showed you on the table, I showed you. Okay? Yes, in this way you have to do. This is the passive form of verb. I ate an apple is eaten by me. It is the same thing but a different way of saying. And we use the passive form initially, I told you, in the reporting. When we report, 17 people were killed in this way. That is that they are using the passive form of verb. In the passive form, two verbs will be there always. Past perfect tense. One example I'll show you, then I'll give you some questions. Same thing. So this is the past perfect tense. The professor had taught the student. Why it is past perfect tense? Because over here we have had over here. You can identify the sentence had over here. So let us change this into passive form. The same procedure. The student had, you copy this down, had. The student had been. By. Okay, so this is the answer. The student had been taught by the professor. So, I hope so you understood the chapter. Now, I will give you some home assignment. Please copy this question in your copy. Just a few. Question is, change these sentences into passive voice. So, number one, Okay, these are four questions. She bought a new house. The boy enjoyed the film. Cats catch mice. Jack beat John. These are four. Copy this down. Give another four. Number five.